is Indians of individuals, Hindu undivided family, association of persons and body of individuals. After ₹2,50,000, the income tax rate is nil. That is, if the total income of an individual is up to ₹2,50,000, rate of tax is nil. On next ₹2,50,000, rate of tax is 5%. On next 5 lakhs, 20%. And on the balance income, 30%. In case of senior citizens, it is senior citizens are those persons whose age is 60 years or above but less than 80 years. Up to ₹3 lakhs, nil. On next ₹2 lakhs, 5%. On next ₹5 lakhs, 20%. And on the balance income, 30%. Next one is in case of super senior citizens, that is persons whose age is 80 years or more. Up to ₹5 lakhs, the rate of tax is nil. On next 5 lakhs, 20%. On balance, 30%. Rebate of income tax is equal to, that is in case of individual resident in India, if the total income of the individual does not exceed ₹3,50,000, then a rebate of ₹2,500 can be claimed. But the condition is, his total income should not exceed ₹3,50,000, then a rebate, it is a deduction of ₹2,500 can be claimed. The next one is surcharge. So rate at 10% is charged if surcharge means additional charge or additional tax. So first, the rate of 10% is charged if the total income of the assessee exceeds ₹50 lakhs but does not exceed ₹1 crore. And surcharge at the rate of 15% is charged if the total income of the assessee exceeds ₹1 crore. This is health and education says 4% is charged on amount of income tax and surcharge. Format for computation of tax of an individual who is neither a senior citizen nor a super senior citizen and assessee has an agricultural income also. So first calculate the total income of the assessee. From the total income to the total income of the assessee, add agricultural income, the total of which is called aggregate income. So next, calculate tax on aggregate income. A, tax on income liable to tax at special rates. So under that you can see casual income, that is winnings from lottery, card games, races, etc. So the tax rate is 30%. Short term capital gain under section 111A, the rate is 15%. Long term capital gain under section 112. On listed securities excluding units or zero coupon bonds computed without indexing the cost of acquisition, in this case the rate of tax is 10%. And regarding other long term capital gains, the rate of tax is 20%. The next one is long-term capital gain under section 112A. The rate of tax is 10%. It is in case of sale of listed equity shares without indexing the cost of acquisition, the sale of listed equity shares exceeds ₹1 lakh. If the sale of listed equity shares exceeds ₹1 lakh, then the rate of tax is 10%. So add up all these items. Now we are going to calculate the tax on balance income. This aggregate income minus income in A at normal rates. That is at rates of income tax applicable for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. So from this, deduct tax on agricultural income plus ₹2,50,000 at normal rates. So total balance and surcharge. Then add health and education cess at 4%. The total will be the gross tax. From the gross tax, deduct tax deducted at source and any advance tax paid by the assessee, and the balance is tax payable by the assessee. If there is no agricultural income, just stop with total income, and we have to calculate tax on balance of income. So tax on agricultural income, this step is not applicable if there is no agricultural income. From the following information, compute the tax payable by Mr. Ram for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. And the given informations are, income from house property computed rupees 80,000, interest on government securities 10,000, long term capital gain under section 112 50,000. So this long term capital gain under section 112 is liable to tax at a special rate of 20%. Income from business 10,55,000. Agricultural income 1 lakh, it is not taxable. Amount withdrawn from PPF 50,000 is also exempted from tax. Purchase NSC 8 issue 30,000. So this amount is eligible for deduction under section 80C. Deposited in PPF, it is public provident fund, rupees 60,000. So this amount is also eligible for deduction under section 80C. The next one is subscription to eligible issue of capital 35,000. And again, this amount is also eligible for deduction under section 80C. Computation of tax payable for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. So first, find out the gross total income of the assessee. In this problem, computed income from house property is given. So directly take the computed income from house property. Income from house property computed is 80,000. Then take income from business 10,55,000. Then take long-term capital gain under section 112, which is 50,000. Then income from other sources, that is interest on government securities 10,000. Amount withdrawn from PPF is not at all taxable. So add up all these incomes, the gross total income comes to 11,95,000. The gross total income, deduct deductions under section 80. The first one is purchase NSC 8 issue. It is eligible for deduction under section 80C and the amount is 30,000. Deposited in PPF, again section 80C, amount is 60,000. Subscription to eligible issue of capital, it is also eligible for deduction under section 80C and the amount of deduction is 35,000. Add up all these amount of deductions and the total amount of deduction comes to rupees 1,25,000 and the overall limit is rupees 1,50,000. In this case, the assessee can claim the entire amount of 1,25,000 under section 80C as deduction. Now deduct 1,25,000 from the gross total income to get the total income of 10,70,000. The next one, find out the aggregate income. In this problem, agricultural income is given. So find out aggregate income of the assessee. So first take the total income of the assessee, which is 10,70,000. To this total income, add agricultural income, which is 1 lakh, and the aggregate income comes to 11,70,000. And the first one, calculate tax on income liable to tax at special rates. In our problem, only one income is liable to tax at special rates, and that is long-term capital gain under section 112 at the rate of 20%. Amount of long-term capital gain is 50,000 and the tax rate is 20%. So 50,000 into 20 by 100, 10,000. The next step, calculate tax on balance income of 11,20,000 at rates applicable for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. And how can we get the balance income? Aggregate income is 11,70,000. Minus long-term capital gain, which is liable to tax at special rate, 50,000. Take the income, don't take the tax amount. So 50,000 balance income is 11,20,000. Now we are going to calculate tax on this balance income at the rate applicable for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. So up to 2,50,000, the rate of tax is nil. So 11,20,000 minus 2,50,000. On this 2,50,000, the tax rate is nil. On next 2,50,000, the tax rate is 5%. So 250,000 into 5 by 100, which is 12,500. On next 5 lakh, the tax rate is 20%. So 5 lakh into 20 by 100, which is 1 lakh. So first we are deducting 250,000. Next again we are deducting 250,000. The balance income at this stage is 6,20,000. Now we are deducting 5 lakh, and the balance income comes to rupees 1,20,000. On the balance income of this 1,20,000, apply 30% tax rate, and the amount of tax is 36,000. Add up all these amount of tax. It is 10,000, 12,500, 1,36,000, and the tax comes to rupees 1,58,500. Tax on income liable to tax at special rates and tax on a balance income of 11,20,000 therefore comes to rupees 1,58,500. From this 1,58,500, deduct tax on agricultural income plus rupees 2,50,000 at normal rates of tax applicable for the assessment year 2019-2020. Here in this problem, the assessee has agricultural income. So that's why we are deducting the tax on agricultural income plus rupees 2,50,000 at normal rates. Amount of agricultural income given in the problem is rupees 1 lakh. So 1 lakh plus rupees 2,50,000, which is equal to 3,50,000. The total income is 3,50,000. Now we are going to apply the rates of tax applicable to the assessment year 2019-2020. So up to rupees, the total income is 3,50,000. Up to rupees 2,50,000, rate of tax is nil. And on the balance, it is 3,50,000 minus 2,50,000. The balance amount is 1 lakh. The rate of tax is 5%. So 1 lakh into 5% is equal to 5,000. So the amount of tax comes to rupees 5,000. Deduct this 5,000 from 1,58,500, and the balance is 1,53,500. Less rebate under section 87A. Here the assessee can't claim rebate of rupees 2,500 because his total income exceeds rupees 3,50,000. So balance is 1,53,500. Add surcharge. Again, here he can't add surcharge because his income, total income, does not exceed rupees 50 lakhs. Therefore, the balance tax is 1,53,500. To this 1,53,500, we are going to add health and education cess at the rate of 4%. So 4% on 1,53,500 comes to rupees 6,140. So add up these two items, 1,53,500 plus health and education cess of 6,140. Tax payable by the assessee is rupees 1,59,640.